good to be in the house of God this morning. Thankful for another day to be here. Appreciate you coming out for the service today and being in the Lord's house. We're thankful for the blessings of life. You pray for all the ones that we've heard about this morning. All the prayer requests have already been turned in. In way of announcements this morning, on Easter morning, we will be flowering the cross, and the church will be providing some flowers, or if you want to bring your own live flower, we're going to put flowers on the cross. That's something new that we're doing this morning, or this year. And so remember that. That'll be next Sunday. We'll have sunrise service at 7 o'clock a.m. Then we'll have breakfast immediately following the service. And then we'll have Easter service next Sunday morning at 10 o'clock, Sunday school and preaching. We won't be having evening service next Sunday night. So be prepared for next Sunday. We're excited about Easter Sunday. Today is Palm Sunday is what they call it. Talking about the Lord's triumphal entry into Jerusalem. And we kind of preached on that a lot last week. And so just reflect on that this week. Reflect on the Holy Week just coming up. Just the Lord's crucifixion, his resurrection. And spend time thinking about that all week long. What a wonderful Savior that we serve. And I'm glad that I'm saved today. Glad that I'm a part of the family of God. But you remember that. So that'd be March 31st, next Sunday. The bridal shower for Avery McNeil and Brady Collin will be April 21st. And then you've got the flyer as well today for the revival. That will be April the 14th to the 17th of Brother William. And Sister Bridget put these flyers in all the bulletins. So if you know of somewhere that you can put this bulletin where that it might reach more people or more of an audience where that they can see it, maybe your local restaurants or gas stations, whatever, just for people to see. We do have a post on Facebook going around as well to share that we're having revival. Brother William, he's well known in this area. He pastored New Bethel for a number of years and has preached several revivals in the area. I actually found in my office in there in the closet, I found a VHS tape from Brother William preaching here in about 2002 or 2003. And I hadn't watched it yet. I got to find me a VHS player. And so I think we've got one downstairs, but I want to watch that. But you pray for Brother William. He's coming to preach for us. He does have leukemia and has been struggling with that for some time, but it's not affected his preaching. I've talked to him on the phone several times, saw him here a while back. So you pray for him as he comes. He's excited about the week, and I hope each of you are as well. And then go ahead and look ahead to the VBS and the summer revival. Put those dates on your calendar as well. And we'll have a good time with both of those as well. It's just a good time of year. Springtime's my favorite time of year. If you can get past all the allergies, I mean, it's a wonderful time of year. And just the trees blooming each week. And I mean, just so much going on around the church. And so we'll have probably a church cleaning day, I guess. Probably we'll schedule that. Miss Sheila may have told me already, but we'll talk to her and announce that before revival. So don't forget that as well. But me and my wife have got an announcement this morning as well. This is a onesie, and so I don't have to tell y'all really what's going on. It says the grand finale, and so it better be the grand finale. I would die if I had four children, but I think three would be enough. But October, the end of October, we'll be having another. And so we're excited. We're praying for a boy. And if it's not a boy, I'm going to go out in the yard and just cry. And just, I mean, I'll be a pitiful shape if it's not a boy. I'm just kidding. I love having girls. And we want the Lord to just give us a healthy baby. So you pray for my wife during the pregnancy. My sister-in-law, Lauren, will be having her baby at the beginning of October. And then ours will be here at the end of October. And if it's a girl, her name's going to be Ivy May. And if it's a boy, his name will be Nolan Reed. So we're going to find out, I think, April the 13th is when we'll find out. But you pray for us. We need your prayers. And we're excited about that. And you just pray for us today. This time we'll go to the Lord in prayer, and then we'll go further in the service. Brother Jerry Scott, would you lead us in prayer this morning?
Heavenly Father, we bow before your throne with grace, thanking you thank you for everything that's happened thus far, the songs that's been sang, the words that's been said. We pray that everything that we say and do for the rest of the service would be bringing honor and glory to you, and church might be lifted up, edified, be with Brother Micah as he preaches this morning. Father, fill him afresh with the Spirit, have him bring to remembrance the things that he has prepared, and present them in a way, in a manner that's pleasing unto you, Lord, that if there's one here lost, that they might come to know you and to be pardoned of sin. Lord, we ask that you just be with each one of the prayer requests that was given in this morning. We pray that you just touch them in a very special way. Those sin sick, Lord, we pray a special prayer for them, Lord, that they have just come to know you before it's everlasting too late. And give you honor, glory, and praise for everything that's accomplished here at Friendship. Be with us in our coming revival. Be with Brother William as he travels back and forth. Heavenly Father, we pray for many souls for his labor. Lord, we just thank you once again.
Amen.
this time, we're going to take up this morning's offering. Brother Phil, probably offering if you would.
Dear God, thank you for this opportunity to be in your house. And Lord, just thank you for the opportunity to give back the force that you blessed us with. I pray, Lord, this money be used for the upbuilding of your kingdom. Lord, I pray for our country. Lord, just be with Israel over there. Lord, I pray for all the prayer requests that have been mentioned, all the ones that are sick. People say a special prayer for all the ones around the area that lost loved ones. Thank you, dear Lord. Lord, just forgive me for my failures.
Amen. Everybody fellowship for. Thank you, church, once again for that. Y'all have been such a blessing to our home and our family. And y'all have made a difference in our life, whether you realize it or not. We was getting ready for bed the other night, and we had the monitor on, the baby monitor. You can see the kids' rooms and both kids trying to go to sleep, and there's nights that Ella, she'll lay awake, and I mean, it'd take her a while to go to sleep. She typically don't want to go to bed, but we told her to go to bed, and we closed the door, and we just let her, after laying there a while, she'll go to sleep. Well, we was listening to her on the monitor, and she got to calling out everybody's name from church. And it got to be funny. It was the most precious thing you ever seen. She got to calling out all the kids, and she named every single kid. And then she said, "And Oscar and Ann." And well, we thought, well, then she went from there to Steve and Linda, and she just went on down through, and y'all have made such a difference in their life, and y'all have been such a blessing, and we appreciate everything that y'all have done for Emily and for our family. Daddy always said growing up, he said, you can treat me how you want to, but be good to my family, and y'all have been good to my family, and y'all have been good to me as well. But we thank the Lord for the opportunity to be here today in the house of God. I want to preach this morning out of the book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 21, and also the gospel according to John, chapter 19. Deuteronomy, chapter 21, and John, chapter 19. We'll go to several scriptures, or I'll be going to several scriptures this morning. If you want to follow along with me, you can. Just for time's sake, though, I'm not going to ask you to turn everywhere that I read, but feel free if you want to. Deuteronomy chapter 21, and I want to read one verse, and then I want to go to John chapter 19. Deuteronomy 21, verse 22, the Bible says here, "And if a man have committed a sin worthy of death, and he be put to death, and thou hang him on a tree, his body shall not remain all night upon the tree, but thou shalt in any wise bury him that day. For he that is hanged is accursed of God, that thy land be not defiled, which the Lord thy God giveth thee for an inheritance." Obviously, the verse here, they probably didn't realize it at the time, but messianic prophecy would be fulfilled with Jesus dying on the cross. John chapter 19, verse number 30, it says, "When Jesus therefore had received the vinegar, he said, 'It is finished,' and he bowed his head and gave up the ghost." And I've been thinking a lot this past week, just meditating upon the crucifixion. And I don't feel worthy to stand and preach on this topic, although this is the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. If a man gets up to preach and he mentions nothing about the cross, he's missed it. And so it takes the unction and the anointing from the Holy Ghost to help a man expound on the Word of God. And I think the gospel is not only the death, the burial, and the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ, but it is the power of God unto salvation. You won't have salvation. You won't have preaching to take place without the power of God. And my text that I read in John chapter 19, it says, "It is finished," and he bowed his head and gave up the ghost. And I want to spend a few minutes this morning just talking about the seven last sayings of the Son of God, or the seven last sayings of the Savior. We know that there were seven last sayings that he had while he was on the cross. And we find the first one in Matthew 27. He would cry out, "Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani," that which is being interpreted, my God, why hast thou forsaken me?" He'd cry out, "Why hast thou forsaken me?" And he had just been ridiculed, mocked, spit upon, hung upon a cross. He was required to carry his own cross. They asked Simon, the man of Cyrene, to help him carry his cross. But they came to a place called Golgotha, that is to say, the place of a skull. And if you see, you can search the pictures online. If you've never been to the Holy Lands, I've never been. I'd like to go one day. But the place where they feel as if this is where the Lord was crucified, it does look like a skull in the side of a rock. And so I could see how it would get that name. But I think about Christ, all that he went through. He so